So friends, I'm Mohammad Azuddin from Webtronics Academy. This is a short video regarding the Google AdWords certification 2018 updates. Because I have created one video in 2016, but a lot of students have asked me a question because 2016 version was the AdWords certification exam we used to take in a different way, and Google have updated this version. So in this video, I'm going to briefly take you to the process of what are the things have changed and what are the process you what are the things you have to do to get this certification. So first of all, this URL has been changed. Previously we used to have this URL on google.com/partners. That URL has been changed. That has been changed to the new version called as Academy for Ads. So you just click on search in Google for Academy for Ads and click on this first URL. So let's go ahead into this first URL. All right, now just when you come to this page, you can just say start now, and I'll go through the various exams and various stuff you can learn from this. So I'm using one new account here. I'm not going with any of the old account. All right, so let's go ahead, log in with your normal Gmail ID, and right, so let's say allow, because they're using a third party LMS system. Okay, so here we are. Okay, I agree with all the terms and conditions and submit. Okay, share my AdWords account information with my company, allow my company profile, activity progress, and want information, valid exams, achievements, such which we share with my associate company in Academy for Ads profile and companies I'm affiliated within the partners. You know, what does it actually mean is, if you want to connect your profile with any of the existing company, which is a Google partner or who are going to be a Google partner, so you can say yes, and then you can proceed to the next. Let me just see, allow my name, profile, activity, progress, enrollment information, valid exams, achievements, and certifications to be shared with my associate company in my Academy for Ads profile, meaning in short, we can connect our Academy for Ads, it's an individual profile, with a company profile, and company profile is a Google partner profile. If you want to share the data, you can say yes. If you're not interested to share the data, you can say no. All right, and this we can also update anytime whenever we want. So as of now, let's go to the normal section and say no, and we'll proceed to the Academy for Ads. So this is actually a very interesting addition where I would also, tell you one very good thing about the new version is Google have really prepared an amazing amount of content for the user purpose. For us, they have created amazing content. Now look at this. They have created segments topic wise. Like you can study AdWords. We can study digital transformation, Android related. Double click, they have created a video. That's a great thing. YouTube, they have created separate videos. For Google My Business, they have created separate content. For analytics, they have created content, and also Google Web Designer. This is a software user for creating advertisements, etc., with animation HTML5. That is a web designer. So it's a great thing, actually. Google have really put up a lot of content, and definitely you can use this content to get a lot of knowledge if you want to go with individual subject. But our interest is AdWords. So click on AdWords. All right, now see this. Now here is our fundamentals. All right, now totally we have six certification exams. There are basically six certification exams available here as well, with some additional exams also added now, which were all already there in previous version also. All right, now here is the option number one. This, okay, fundamentals, search, which is very important, fundamentals, and these are all certification exams. Fundamentals, then search, then display, then mobile, then video, and shopping ads, and display brandness and brand and control, and then we got digital sales, brand controls for AdWords display campaign. Okay, this is different one. These are not directly relevant. These are just not examination. These are not certifications. All right, this all are just for knowledge purpose, just for knowledge purpose. Even this is also knowledge purpose. Now wherever you see this symbol, that's actually a option we can use that for certification. So what I should do here is simple. In previous version we have did, in earlier version we have to, same concept was there but not in detail. All right, now go ahead and click on AdWords fundamentals. Yep, Now here you can start learning. If you feel like, sir, I have to study this first, and obviously you have to first study, learn the basics of AdWords. In 8 minutes, they have given some data, how much time it will take to go through this resource. Either it's a video or is a audio or is a combination, doesn't matter. Now see, I'll go with all of this one by one. And very nice design also. Content is also designed in a very nice and easy to understand format. All right, so like this, I can go through each chapter and I can complete all this, you know, one step by step, all these examinations from start to end. I hope you got the simple point here. So I can go through all of these exams one by one, one by one. I'll complete all the options so that I can understand the fundamental concepts of the AdWords. All right. Now here, once I complete, you have to go through all and this option. And now it's time to test your knowledge. It's same 1.5 hours exam. So click on AdWords fundamental assessment. All right. Now it is 65 questions. Now that's a great news. Earlier in exam, we used to have 100 questions and 120 minutes. 2 hours paper was there. But today it's changed to 65 questions and time limit is just 90 minutes and pass percentage as usual 80%. All right. Now let's see the other version just to get an idea. Okay. Search advanced. Great. Let's go with assessment and see. Before we come to this exam, prerequisite is first you have to complete this. All right. Okay. So let me go through the mock exam also. So in the video, it's some recording will take a few questions. So you'll understand how easy this exam really is. Launch the exam. Okay. Simple question. Laura runs an online store. Let's look at this. With a variety, with large inventory of children's toys and games. All right. Company runs, okay, so online store. Which ad format would you use for Laura's campaign to reach people interested in purchasing children games? A simple concept, because see, Laura is actually selling toys and games online. It's an online store, meaning it's an e-commerce website. And what is the goal? The goal of Laura is she wants to reach people who are interested to buy. So as simple as that, app promotion, no. Image ads, no. Site links, no. Answer is shopping ads. Simple, straightforward question. Done. Next, the client who owns an online shoe store wants to deliver drive sales of a particular model of women's running shoes. What keyword should you include in the client's keyword list to help achieve their goals? This is actually the exam question for keyword match types. Specific terms about benefits of running? No. Generic terms about different types of women's shoes? No. Generic terms about running and running shoes, no. Specific terms about shoe brand and model your client is selling. All right, let me just go back again. I want to be runs an online shoe store, wants to drive sales of particular model of women's running shoes. Particular model. All right. Particular model, right? I want to go with that model. So see here, I want to go with specific term about the shoe brand and model of the client is selling. So 4 is the answer. So like this, you see, I can, if you would like to like your ads to show on certain sites across the internet, you can add these websites. Okay, placements. You can add these websites as placements. Simple question. Easy, it's a display campaign. Which bid strategy should Sarah use if her goal is to get more people to call her local catering business? All right, let me read again. Which bid strategy should Laura use if her goal is to get more calls for her local catering business? Conversions, so CPA, because the call is also a kind of conversion, so she has to use the CPA to get as many calls as possible to the local. So that's every call is a conversion. Google Analytics can help you learn more about the behavior of your client's customer because it shows you how likely they become a regular customer. They interact with her website. Likely they are click on her ads. They perceive her products. They interact with her website. We can actually know how the user have interacted. Then we can actually analyze that data. Next, a standard AdWords text ad is made up of. Okay, this is a very, actually it is an irrelevant question. I'll tell you why. Because the concept of standard ad is already discontinued. Okay, in terms of our normal ad, right now we only have expanded ad, correct? So if I'm teaching in the class also, we'll discuss mostly expanded ad only. But technically a standard ad, maybe they're considering here expanded also. Headline text and description, no. Headline text and image and description, no. Headline text, display URL and description text. Yeah, answer is C. But actually display URL is now converted. The name is now converted to display path. Okay, let's say next. Next, which is the best bidding option for an advertiser who wants to drive more clicks from mobile devices? Okay, mobile bid adjustments, as simple as that. We have one concept, mobile bid adjustment. Simple, easy. Okay, Nadia manages a local gym and is running an ad to drive more free trials membership. What could she include in her ad text? Okay, I want to include the conversions. Promotion like 20% off fitness classes, no. A call to action like visit our gym now, no. A prominent headline like trial memberships available, no. Because it's all capitals, it will reject it. A call to action like, yeah, sign up for a free trial, a good option. Next. Why might you use the search network campaigns to display opt-in campaign type? Okay, logically, I would never recommend any client to use this. That's the reality. Okay, never ever use search network with display opt-in. It's one of the waste campaign type. I personally don't prefer at all. Use search separate, display separate. It's much more controlled. Okay, so most of the professional AdWords users, they will always differentiate search with display. Okay, what is the actual benefit is, you can pick up the exact website where you want to show your ads, no. Your video ads run on network, no. You can use one budget to advertise. Yeah, that's actually the only reason. If someone have very low budget and you want to adjust it between the two. So the biggest benefit is one budget to advertise to both search and display network. That's the answer. Okay, simple. Negative keywords can help advertisers better target their ads. Why? Negative keyword means one match type where it will eliminate the clicks and impressions, increases the number of relevant display network placement, wrong, raises the average position of the ads, wrong, reduce the number of irrelevant clicks, right. The basic idea of our concept is this only. Yes. All right. Go ahead and say next. So like this, actually we can complete the entire exam, but you please do some hard work and learn it, and then you do the, you write this exam, and definitely you will pass this exam. If you do study that all the chapters and give some time for practical and learning also, definitely you can work out. All right, so I hope you understood how to, you know, be a certified professional. And you can first write this exam, then second search. Minimum two exams are compulsory. If you want to write all the exams, you can write. I have some of my students have written all the complete exams as well. That is also a good strategy to differentiate yourself from all the other job seekers in the job market. If you're more certified, certifications you did, even freelancing also, you can get good number of projects based on your qualified, you know, resume. So that is one option. Benefit of certification technically is, in job point of view, you have more preferences, and also in terms of freelancing and other option, you will have a added advantage. And if you are looking for a video program, if you want to study in a step-by-step manner, so I would also, you can also join our video program on, you can check our site webtrainings.in/videos, and under that you can go for a free trial. And you can register for a free trial, and free of cost, you can see an initial demo video. If you are, if you like our demo session, then you can also opt for the complete video program as well, which is a paid program. What is the advantage of our program would be, you will learn everything in a step-by-step manner. You don't need to go here and there and do a lot of hard work and struggle to get the info, because I will share my experience with the paid program itself. So I hope you got the point, and I would request who have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel, and also share our videos with your friends as well. Thank you very much.